Hello and a very warm welcome to the weekend edition of Buy Now, Sell Now. I'm Kamya Jani Verma. Well, we have lots lined up on the show, discussing many stocks as well as getting you some investment ideas on Axis Bank as well as BPCL. In addition to that, on our portfolio advisor segment, we'll be addressing Shreyas Shah's portfolio on the show. And to answer all your stock-related queries and address that portfolio, we have experts with us. Sharmila Joshi of sharmilajoshi.com as well as Mandar Jamchandekar of Precision Technical Analysis. Hi there and a very warm welcome to Buy Now, Sell Now Weekend. First up, we have a query from BP Singh, who is from Bhopal. Now he wants to know whether this is a good time to invest in Axis Bank for the next 2 to 3 years. Mandar would like to know your thoughts as well on the technicals. Last 1 week, though, it has been good for Axis Bank. It gained about 1.5%. But over a medium term, how are you viewing Axis Bank and what are the chart patterns indicating to you?
Kamya. See, there are plenty of stocks which are moving up. I believe investing in the stock markets is like an Olympic 100-meter race where you have got 10 competitors, but you would always want your stock to be the Usain Bolt in that race. So the same thing applies here. If I look at the long-term chart, then from 2013, the stock was trading at 152. From there, the stock rallied to make a high of 655 in March of 2015. So the stock has already witnessed a rally where the price has more than tripled. Then the price witnessed the sharp correction of 50% of this up move, which brought it down to approx 360 levels. Though the price in the last 5 months is trying to do a catch up with the overall markets, the chart suggests that as it moves up further, it may face a major resistance between a band of 590 and 620. So there's a big supply zone between this band. And this supply would be from the old buyers who had bought the stock in the first half of 2015 in the rally and failed to trigger their stop losses. So they were stuck for the last 1 year. And now as the price approaches that level, I believe they would be tempted to exit and shift to other performing stocks, and this will automatically apply brakes to the short-term up move witnessed in the stock right now. Therefore, the stock and just because the stock is trading below major supply zone, I think it would not be right for us to take a long-term view at this point of time. I would suggest that in this stock, one should have a wait-and-watch approach. In the short to medium term, it surely does not look to be a champion in the race. For the next 6 months, I do not expect Axis Bank to outperform, and therefore I would suggest the investor to look at stocks like HDFC Bank, IndusInd Bank and Kotak Bank from the private banking space.
Okay, so that's a word coming in from Mandar Jamchandekar. HDFC Bank, IndusInd as well as Kotak Bank are more preferred stocks over Axis Bank, and you should rather have a wait and watch approach as far as Axis Bank is concerned. Well, let's move on and then get in Mandar's views as well on BPCL and see how the chart patterns have really panned out over the last 1 month. Stock has seen a stellar move, 12.5% of an uptick that's come in, 65 odd points added up to its gains. And the rally clearly has taken off over the last 3 months as well, 22% of gains that's come in for BPCL. Mandar, what's your sense? Do you expect the rally to continue as far as BPCL is concerned? At least that's what the technicals are suggesting.
Kamya, rightly said, the stock has performed very well in the short term. Now, when I look at the long-term chart of BPCL, then it tells me that the right time to buy the stock was when it gave a breakout in March of 2014. That was at the bonus adjusted price of 230. If I had missed this trade, then the second invitation for me to buy the stock was on 27th of May this year, when the price had closed at 509. This breakout was after a consolidation of 1 year. The reason for me to specify these dates is that during these periods, if I had entered a trade, then the risk to rewards ratio would have been in my favor. Now, at the current levels, though the stock trades in an uptrend, there is no invitation on the price chart which may make me want to buy the stock. But because the trade is already done, if I have to justify this trade, then on the short-term charts, when I look at the short-term charts, they tell me that the stock for the last 5 months is trading in a nice uptrend, making higher tops and higher bottoms. If this trend has to continue, then going forward, the price should not go below the earlier bottom of 543. So this level of 543 should be watched as a major support for the stock going forward. The breakout which the stock gave on 27th of May 2016 suggested a price target of approx 700, and it looks like the momentum that we've been observing currently in as the price moves can help the stock price achieve this target. The reason for us to hold this position in is the trend, and therefore I think the investor should keep a stop loss below a level of at around 540, which is below the support of the earlier bottom, and expecting the stock price in the next 3 to 6 months, I expect that the momentum can take the stock up by 10 to 20%. So there is still some more upside left in the stock, so he can hold on, keep a stop loss at 540, expect a target of an upside of 10 to 20% in the next 3 to 6 months.
Okay, that's an optimistic call coming in on BPCL. Mandar clearly expects the stock to reach the 700 mark. Bear in mind, there is a stop loss as well that you need to monitor. 700 and 10 to 20% of an upside over the next 3 to 6 months. Great to have you back with us on the weekend edition of Buy Now, Sell Now. Time then to get an outlook on the markets as well as some trading ideas. Nifty, well, this week it has gained about more than 1%, and we saw similar moves coming in for the Sensex, and the broader markets is where all the action was. Getting a view then from our experts, Mandar would like to know, what are the key levels that you would be mapping out for in the coming week as far as Nifty is concerned?
Kamya, I expect the Nifty to remain range bound. Basically the short term trend for the Nifty continues to remain up. For the last 5 to 6 months, the Nifty is respecting the uptrend line plotted joining all the lows right from February this year. The value for this trend line is at the current closes at 8350. This means that this level is a major support for the Nifty, and till the time this is not broken on the downside, there's no reason for us to be bearish on the index. Now at current levels, the Nifty has reached a resistance band between 8600 and 8700, from where it had witnessed selling during July and August of 2015. So therefore, this is a resistance. Now along with this, the current rally from 7700 to the recent highs of 8675 has virtually been a straight rally. And for these two reasons, the speed of the moves displayed by the Nifty lately has slowed down. So in the immediate short term, one needs to watch a resistance band between 8650 and 8700. And if the Nifty has to break this past this band, then it needs to get support from the broader market, and it will mainly need support from the banking Nifty is what I feel, which also trades just below major resistance at 19200. Once the bank Nifty crosses 19,200, I believe the Nifty will start its journey towards its next goal, which would be the all-time high at 9,100. But till this happens, and for the coming week, I think the Nifty would consolidate at current levels. The consolidation can see the Nifty trade between 8,500 and 8,700 as a short-term range. Individual stocks may continue to outperform the markets, but at current levels, investors should be selective in picking stocks. The markets will present us with plenty of opportunities, and therefore one should avoid temptations of jumping onto stocks which have already rallied or which are already in the move, as they may not fit in the risk to rewards ratio.
Mandar, over to you then, and for somebody looking for trading ideas, what is it that you have on your list?
Your first one would be LIC Housing Finance. This stock for the last one and a half year has been consolidating between a support at 390 and a resistance at 515. For the last 2 weeks, as the stock trades above this range and beyond the resistance at 515, it suggests that it is getting ready for a fresh rally. At current levels, we should watch a band between 515 and 505 as a support for the stock. Above this band, the bullish view will remain intact. The fresh momentum should be able to take the stock up is what I believe. It can take it up by 15 to 20% from the current levels with a 3 to 6 month view, and therefore looks good to buy with a stop loss at 490 for a target of 640. And the second stock is Havells. This stock looks good on the short, medium as well as long term charts, so daily, weekly as well as monthly charts. So triple confirmation in this stock is what we have. On the short term charts, the stock has a support at 370. And a recent breakout for an up-flag formation in the stock should help the stock trade in strong hands is what I think. Buy with a stop loss at 365 for a target of 440 expected to be achieved in the coming 1 to 3 months.
Okay, so it's LIC Housing Finance as well as Havells. Thanks very much, Sharmila, as well as Mandar, for taking time out and sharing those top trading ideas with us on Buy Now, Sell Now Weekend. Well, that completely out of time on this edition. Thanks for watching.